Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Yes. Welcome. We're excited to begin this guaranteeing comfort artist. We're going to wait just only a few minutes before everyone arrives. Appreciate that you are here. We have some music for you while we wait. Hope you like it. Yes, we are so happy to see everyone here. Appreciate it. We all appreciate it in this space. In this guaranteed income for artists, for artists. Name, pronouns, and where are you calling from in the chat. We appreciate that we have Transcend here with us today, and they're here to help us with all the tech that we need. So if you need something, please message Transcend Chiara or Transcend Liana in the chat. We also have Inclusive Communication Service are here to provide ASL interpretation. If you need, please message Transcend Chiara so we know to be sure to put you in the right Zoom breakout room later in our program. Appreciate everyone that is coming. Yeah. To all the people that are joining, remember to put your name, pronouns, and where you're calling from in the chat. And also, you can add why you decide to join us for today's session. Why not? Thank you, Melissa. I think we are ready to begin with the Guaranteed Income for Artists workshop. Welcome, everyone.
Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome. We're so happy you're here with us tonight, this evening. My name is Randy Berry. My pronouns are she, her, hers. I'm the executive director and co-founder of IndieSpace, and we're so thrilled you're here. I want to take a moment before we start to introduce or allow my team to introduce themselves. So go ahead, Vishante.
Hi, everyone. I'm Vishante Brown. I use they, she pronouns, and I am the programs manager at IndieSpace.
Hi, everyone. My name is India Chanel. I'm the project manager of IndieSpace, she, her, hers pronouns.
Hi everyone, thank you for being here. My name is Joel Guzman. I'm the community engagement in this space. Pronouns he, him.
Thank you, team. And just a quick reminder, you can access ASL interpretation through Zoom using the interpretation button. You just select American Sign Language. There should be a globe if you don't see it. You can select American Sign Language. If you're using ASL, please message Transcend Kira in the chat so that we can be sure that you are assigned to the appropriate breakout room when we move into breakout rooms. Okay. So, I want to start our gathering with a land acknowledgement. Every community owes its existence and vitality to generations from around the world who contributed their hopes, dreams, and energy to make the history that led to this moment. Some were brought here against their will, some were drawn to leave their distant homes in hope of a better life, and some have lived on this land for generations, more generations than can be counted. So I would like to begin today by acknowledging that I'm coming to you from the ancestral and unceded territory of the Munsee, Lenape, Canarsie, and Matinecock people. We acknowledge them as the past, present, and future caretakers of this land, and we pay respects to their elders, past and present. Please take a moment to consider the many legacies of violence, displacement, migration, and settlement that bring us here today. A land acknowledgement is one important way to remind ourselves of this land and our history, but it is important to also go beyond the land acknowledgement. One of the ways that IndieSpace has historically done that is by contributing and giving unrestricted grants to Native theater companies in our community. And another way that we've just started contributing that I just learned about, so I want to share with you all, is through contributing a voluntary land tax. The West Village Rehearsal Co-op just started paying this voluntary land tax through the Manna-Hatta Fund. And if you would like to do the same and contribute to the Manna-Hatta Fund, we're going to put the link in the chat. Okay. So we're going to move to India, who's going to talk to us a little bit about community guidelines and the setup for tonight.
Yes, thank you, Randy. So on the slide here, we do have a few agreements, guidelines that we'd like for you all to consider as we go through this workshop. The first one is going to be respectful brainstorming. So this is a respectful place for brainstorming. So we ask everyone to please be considerate of others and ideas and perspectives. Share time equitably. Be mindful of how much time we have as we share. So keep your contributions concise to allow everyone a chance to speak. Step up and step back. If you tend to speak a lot, especially on this topic, because for me, this is a soapbox, I'm so excited for this discussion. Just be sure to make room for others. Now, if you tend to stay in the background and try to challenge yourself to share a thought, we'd really, really encourage you all to step up. We re really encourage it. Permission to speak and draft in this space. Now, thoughts may not be fully thought out, which is totally fine. We offer grace to our community members. So please speak and draft as you speak, as you please. And what is learned here leaves here. And what is specifically shared here stays here. So we encourage you to speak about guaranteed income for artists. That is the whole point of this workshop. But if there's any specific things that are shared that may be a intimate conversation be between others in the group, we just ask everyone to be respectful and mindful of that it will stay here. And lastly, assume good intent. So let's commit to address intent to harm if and when it happens. So as long as you receive with an open heart and leave with an open heart, I think we're going to have a really good time. So thank you all. And next, I'll move it over to Vishante.
I have just a couple of housekeeping notes on the tech stuff. So, a lot of this you guys should already remember if you've for all the times that we've been on Zoom, but let's remember to please stay on mute until you're ready to speak. This will help minimize any background noise that we have and help mitigate interruptions. We do have ASL interpretation. You can view that ASL interpretation by clicking the globe icon at the bottom menu bar in Zoom that says interpretation, then select ASL, American Sign Language. If you need the ASL interpretation, please make sure that you message Transcend Kira in the chat that you will be using the ASL so we can make sure that we put you in the correct breakout room later. Another thing about accessibility, if you to turn on captions, please click the CC button at the bottom of the Zoom window and select Show Subtitles. We're asking people to use the raise hand feature in Zoom if you would like to speak or ask a question. This is just going to help us manage the flow of the conversation because there's so many people in the Zoom. And but please feel free to use the chat function with any comments or questions to connect with each other, anything like that. The chat function is open to you. And if you have any technical issues or any questions like that, please send a direct message to either Transcend Kira or Transcend Liana, and they will help you.
Thank you, Vishante. So I'm going to do a brief intro on IndieSpace and why we're here today for any folks that might be new and unfamiliar with IndieSpace. IndieSpace is a community organizer, is an industry co-op, and a service mechanism for indie theater makers in New York City. We provide grants, professional development, real estate programs, community connection, and advocacy for this group of artists. We're advocating all the time on behalf of this community. And with all of the transition and difficulty that we've been feeling in the field at this moment, the retraction of philanthropy, the rising costs of goods and labor, the affordability crisis as far as housing is concerned, our grants can only go so far. So we believe, I believe personally, that the thing that can stabilize us as artists, as people, and is also in line with anti-poverty work and people is guaranteed income. So we believe we need indie space grants and services on top of a guaranteed income for artists. So this workshop today is doing a little bit of all the things that we do. It is bringing the community together and gathering us to talk and brainstorm. It is about being in community with one another. It's taking an opportunity to learn about guaranteed income so that we can advocate for guaranteed income. And what we hope is that we're going to take the information that we learned today. We are, not we hope, we will be taking the information that we learn here today and we'll be building a funding program from this workshop today. So we're here for the two reasons, right? We're here to spread good word about guaranteed income, and we're here to design an indie space guaranteed income program. We're going to start with learning a little bit of the basics around guaranteed income. And many of you know that about Creatives Rebuild New York. If you do know about Creatives Rebuild, or if you participated, please let us know in the chat. Feel free to use the chat to talk and communicate with one another. But Creatives Rebuild New York was a 3-year, $125 million program that provided 2,400 artists $1,000 a month for 18 months, no strings attached. They also had a workforce program that provided full-time employment for a period of time. Mara's here and she can answer that, but for 300 artists. I've been in working groups with Creatives Rebuild New York for the last 8 months or so, unpacking the impact of the GI program, and thinking through other cash for artists programs, brainstorming on services and resources and policy, for the creatives as Creatives Rebuild sunsets, which is happening at the end of this year. I've learned a lot doing this work with Creatives Rebuild. And so I was thrilled to be able to partner with them to make sure we could share information with our community about guaranteed income. I'm going to introduce Mara Cuffey, who's here with us tonight from Creatives Rebuild New York. So, in her own words, she can tell you a little bit about that guaranteed income program.
Randy, we're here.
We did it. We're here.
I'm so thrilled. Thank you so much for making space and including me in this really phenomenal occasion. There's 62 people on this Zoom. Like, come on, y'all. This is what I'm Randy hears me talk about. I'm finding myself more and more often in economic justice spaces that know about artists, but maybe aren't as deeply rooted in what it means to be an artist and how important artistry and cultural strategy is to our larger movement work. What I often tell those folks is like, we bring a crowd, you know, like we're 60 deep on Zoom. No one wants to do Zoom anymore. And there's 60 of us here. Like, I'm so thrilled about that. Just briefly, I'll name, as Randy mentioned, Creative Rebuild New York was always intended to be a short-term initiative to really address artists' needs, right, in the interim. But we also always knew that there was a bigger, the stakes were much higher, right, than the timeline of our work. And also that the bigger win is a permanent policy win, and policy both with a capital P and a lowercase p, right? If more of us, meaning those of us who are doing the moving of money, sharing of resources, mutual aid work, are leaning into the principles of a guaranteed income, right? Which is no strings attached, which is trust the people because they are trustworthy, moving the money directly into people's pockets, right? Not for a project or for some subjective opinion on what artistic excellence is, just simply because we are, period, deserving. The more we can be doing that, the better for all of us. I'm so excited about what this could mean for the indie space community, because the more of us are advocating for guaranteed income and doing guaranteed income, the more promising the movement is. And when I just say the movement, what I'm describing is the real reality. That's awkward, but you know what I'm saying there. The reality that there are literally, I think now, over 150 different guaranteed income pilots across the US, not exclusively for artists, but for all kinds of folks. The more that artists are working and thinking in solidarity with other progressive movements, such as economic justice and guaranteed income being an important solution amongst those, the more likely we are to win for all. Anything else you wanted me to chime in on there, Randy?
No, we're just really happy to have you here and your expertise in the room. So we'll probably be, we may tag team you back in at some point if the conversation goes in that direction. Whoever gets Mara in the breakout room, lucky, right?
But that's, hear all that's of it. My mistakes and all of the things. I can't wait for y'all to amend and edit and do more brilliantly than we ever could. So thanks.
Well, thank you for being here. And I think we're really fortunate to have your program to point to and to look at what the, you know, what a tremendous success it was, and also places where we feel like a program like ours might intersect differently or do things differently, take the learnings from all of your work for the years that you've done it and put it into practice in our program. So thanks for that. I'm going to move, I'm trying to read so I remember to say everything, move it up to this part of my screen. So I just want to, we're going to start by learning a little bit about guaranteed income, and then we're going to move into the part where we brainstorm about what IndieSpace's guaranteed income program will look like. But I wanted to set the stage a little bit. IndieSpace has been trying for years to get funding for a guaranteed income program, and we have not had success yet in bringing in enough, or what I was thinking was enough money to get us started. A program like this takes a tremendous amount of cash and a tremendous amount of capacity, and IndieSpace is still a small organization. We used to be smaller though. And as a small and responsive organization, we often were creating programs in a moment of urgency and when a sudden need arised or was like, you know, showed up for us. And we would do so with whatever resources we had at the time. And then in the best case scenario, when we did it, people would join us and they would give us more money to expand that program. And so we've been putting it out there that we wanted to build it. and the money hadn't come. And so at the urging of some very loud members of our artist committee, our nitty gritty artist committee, and a former board member, a founding board member, Brad Burgess, we just decided that we were gonna build something and then they will come. That is the decision we decided to make. And so that is the spirit that we're coming to this conversation with. And there is a lot of interest. There's 64 people on the Zoom, but over 200 people asked for the link to the Zoom today. Lots and lots of people asked for a recording. And we have over 70 people RSVP'd for the in-person workshop that we're doing tomorrow. So my community is telling me loudly and clearly that this is what they want from us. And we're gonna do our best to create something that feels impactful and is representative of this, of our community. So we'll get into more about what that we think that might look like after we spend a few minutes now learning a little bit more about the nuts and bolts of guaranteed income. So we have a couple of videos to show you. They're 20 minutes combined. One of them is, I think, 7 minutes and the other is 13 minutes. And these were videos that were created in partnership with Creatives Rebuild New York, CreativeStudy, Art.coop, and I'm missing someone. I can't. I'll remember. Thank you, thank you, Mara. Okay, enjoy, everybody. They're a lot of fun. See you in a minute.
One, two, three.
Let's get into it.
Me too. Let's get into it.
I really like your hair.
Thank you. I like your eyeshadow.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Eshe Shukura, and I'm a writer, playmaker, and currently the cultural strategist at the Georgia Resilience and Opportunity Fund, where we practice bold solutions to ending poverty.
Hi, I'm Naja Gordon. I'm an artist, and I'm the program manager for the Guaranteed Income for Artists programs at Creative Rebuild New York. This video is about guaranteed income, a term that we dig into throughout this video, but I want to start with some ways that artists have shared their economic realities with us. Eshe, I wonder if any of these resonate for you?
Working two jobs and still barely scraping by. Mm-hmm.
Chasing small-time, low-paying gigs to make your bills.
Yes.
Feeling tired all the time working to pay your rent.
I'm sleepy right now.
And waiting forever for a grant to come through.
That is the one. I wish I could say no, but I've heard these time and time again. Those of us who are working class, poor, including artists, know far too well that no matter how many grant cycles and gigs we put together, it's still a struggle to make ends meet.
The economic system we live in is built for financial precarity for the 99% and for extreme wealth and comfort for the 1%. If you're struggling to meet your basic needs or feel constant anxiety about slipping into a financial emergency, it is not your fault. Let's look at the facts. Earnings in the U.S. have barely increased since the 1970s, yet prices keep going up. Nearly half of Americans do not have the financial resources to cover a $400 emergency.
In this fractured system, people simply don't have enough money. This is especially true for those of us who are disabled, living in rural areas, Black, Indigenous, people of color, queer, and trans.
But it doesn't have to be this way. There are straightforward ways to help people get what they need. Cash, and specifically guaranteed income, which is what this whole course is about. So, what is guaranteed income?
Let me tell you, guaranteed income is recurring cash payments for individuals that is unconditional, meaning you don't have to do something with the cash to prove you are deserving. Guaranteed income is supplemental, meaning it works well with other social safety nets.
People also talk about universal basic income.
Yeah, and they're connected, but there are key differences. Universal is for everyone. Guaranteed is targeted. One way I like to think about guaranteed income is that it's designed for people who are owed this. It's not welfare, it's a needed payback. For every laborer who makes profits under unlivable wages, for the descendants of people who were deemed property, for youth born under circumstances that they should not have to operate in, for caregivers, aunties, and mamas whose necessary care work goes unnoticed, to us, artists who illustrate our stories and birth light into the world, only to have our work largely undervalued by institutions. Pay us, all of us. Economic stability is a prerequisite to economic prosperity. Basically, cash makes shifts happen. We need stability to build wealth.
I love that. I think the key here is that it's about getting cash with no restrictions into people's hands, which is a very different approach to how other benefits programs work, let alone grants. Giving people money that's not tied to work sounds great, but also too good to be true. I bet you're wondering, how could this ever happen?
It's not a wild dream. The government has intervened with cash before. Check it out. Congress passed the Mother's Pension, the country's first welfare program that distributed cash monthly to single mothers, a concept widely accepted by most and replaced by aid to needy families. There's also the New Deal and the GI Bill as well. Each one of these offered the possibility of income stability and even wealth building. However, they also came with stipulations that often excluded Black people and communities of color. Besides policy, the concept of guaranteed income has been a part of the radical movement for liberation for the last several decades. For example, the welfare rights movement, where Black women leaders like Ruby Duncan, Johnny Tillman, and other welfare recipients advocated for guaranteed income and exposed the prejudice of the welfare system. Their work made way for leaders like Martin Luther King to name in his infamous text, Chaos or Community, guaranteed income as the simplest and most effective solution to poverty.
That history reminds me of two things. One, that economic insecurity did not happen magically. People made it this way. And two, we can change it. Guaranteed income is not a pipe dream. It's happening right now. For example, our homies at Yerba Buena Center for the Arts with the City of San Francisco and Springboard for the Arts in Minnesota were some of the first to lead the way in guaranteed income for artists. Here, at CRNY, 2,400 artists across New York State receive $1,000 a month for 18 consecutive months between 2022 and 2024.
It's definitely happening now, and it's happening in all shapes and sizes. Did you know that Alaska has been redistributing wealth to all Alaskans for decades through their permanent dividend fund? Remember when we all got our STEMIs or the child tax credit? Those are forms of cash policy as well. At the Grow Fund, we have a program called In Her Hands, where we move $850 per month for 24 months, focusing on Black women in three Georgia communities, one rural, one urban, and one suburban. Guaranteed income is one part of building a better safety net for people. That safety net includes higher wages, free childcare, and free higher education, all of which are common in social democracies. In countries where the solidarity economy is strong, consistent income is one part of a larger project of ensuring that all people have an economic floor.
Imagine what our mutual aid networks could do if our communities were more resourced. Imagine what else we could be doing if we weren't stressed about bills all the time. What choices would you make, and what art would you make? Guaranteed income is about more than cash. It's about what's possible when we live beyond survival.
Artists can and should be a part of this movement. With more people and more support, we can go from pilot to policy and make permanent change a reality. Let's watch this documentary to understand what it feels like for people who receive it.
We need to tell the story of this work. Do you agree with me? We need to tell the story of this work, and you are the story of this work. Black movement workers over decades and decades remind us that we need to leave evidence that we were here.
so pumped we're here today. We're at Riverside Church in Harlem. First of all, Harlem, shout out to Harlem, what an important place. Creatives Rebuild New York is operating a statewide guaranteed income program for artists. They support 2,400 artists all across the state, which is a really big place, 62 counties. And what we hear from folks all the time is, can we get together? What's everyone doing? They want to share experiences about what it's like to be an artist, to be a working artist, to share struggle and also share joy and share triumph. And so we're here today to do just that, to bring the artists together. It's going to be a really good time. We're in a period of transition in the program. 18 months with $1,000 a month, no strings attached, is, I hope, a really meaningful experience for folks. We also know that 18 months is not the same as a lifetime, right, guarantee. So we're here because as people are transitioning, as the program is beginning to end, the answer to transition is community. And that's what this event is really aiming to do, bring people together, break bread together, and support each other through change. Hi, I'm Mara Cuffey Peterson. I'm the Director of Strategic Initiatives for Guaranteed Income at Creatives Rebuild New York. Guaranteed income is an economic policy intervention that is very simple and very powerful. It's a program that is about moving cash directly into the hands of people in a consistent way. So we're talking about monthly. It's meant to go to individuals. It's meant to be no strings attached. You don't have to work or do something to deserve that cash. It's supposed to build an economic floor that no one can fall below. We all deserve dignity. So it's not money to do an art project, although you can if you want, right, in the context of our program. It can mean so many things. It can mean being able to breathe.
It was surreal. And like, you know, I've been having some conversation with folks here and it's like, is this really like every month it's like, okay, I'm getting it, right? Like, oh, I got it. Nice. Every month it's like, oh, we're really getting this. With that income, I was able to buy my camera, the camera that I'm shooting with here today. I couldn't buy the camera until I had like 2 to 3 months of the GI, with the guaranteed income coming in. It felt like a huge investment on me as a person, on me as a creative, you know, in my practice. And I was able to save money, which is like, I can't believe I saved money in New York City. Also, it's not easy to talk about because there's the conversation of like, why am I worthy and privileged enough to have received this funds when I know there are other folks who applied for it and didn't get it. And there are other people who really need it and maybe didn't know of the opportunity.
I got it. And then I didn't accept it right away. I was scared or whatever was going on in my mind. And I was in the hospital in and out with my mom. You guys had people in the neighborhood who help us with the process? Yeah. So the woman called me and she said, I found out you haven't accepted yet. You are one of the people who really deserve this. And I accepted, and then my mom died. It was because of her. I need to thank GI for keeping me with a roof over my head. And I'm like, oh my God, I didn't use it for art. What am I doing? But I started working and got a part-time job. I started performing again. Thank you. My mom's 1 year anniversary is coming up, so I have to thank her. And I decided, because I couldn't use the money for art, that I was gonna start a separate bank account where I put some of the money that's coming in for the rest of this for when I'm ready to use it for the arts. So I wanna thank you for that and for my rebirth coming for part two. Thank you.
There's so much help out there that is like, well, you gotta jump, you gotta swim, you gotta sing, you gotta dance. What you coming up with? What are you selling? Who's your mother, right? And you know, this really honored where everyone's artistry is coming from. So for me, GI has been just
amen. That's another conversation that we were having this past week of the difference between guaranteed income and grants. And like the whole process of getting grants is like, you have to show yourself in your best light. And like, just hustle so that you make sure that like every word that you put in that an application counts, every, you know, like every piece of artwork that you put in there counts, and like it's, you know, tip top, and kind of like your whole like personality and essence and being is hanging on that, right? And if you don't get the grant, you're like, shit, I have to talk to myself, okay, I'm worthy even though I didn't get this. And like remind ourselves that we are worthy and that our work is important no matter what. If we get grants, if we get funding or not. And so I think the guaranteed income felt like, yeah, a breath of, you know, fresh air, just a deep sigh of like, I have this safety net.
Right now we're in a world where we need money to make things work, right? So I see guaranteed income as a step towards the future that we want. And we're seeing that future lived presently in this program. It's more than just a check. It's all these other things.
With this coming to an end, I feel a lot more hopeful and a lot more accepting and loving of ourselves. And be able to say that I love myself, and that's something that I won't let go of.
It is by being, by proactively being, representing exactly who I am through and through, and literally despite those who say I'm not supposed to. So that's what I got, and I thank you.
This has been so wonderful. I've been able to bask in the abundance of the universe and just feel really cared for and like protected. So I thank you all, and I trust that this was wonderful for you as well.
I want to say it helped me a lot because I ended up needing like prescriptions and different things. Some things went awry and I was like, look at God, because I would have been struggling and thinking about how am I going to grab from Peter and pay Paul. So this was a blessing, and the timing was incredible. It was definitely a blessing.
It was a very, really rough like summer with my health, and I think it's because I was being overworked. I was working too much. I wasn't taking care of myself. Guaranteed income allowed me to like just like step back and be like, okay, now have fun. So I don't need to, you know, work myself to death here. And also, you know, I could do more of my projects. My photography has just gone off the roof because I've had more time to dedicate to like experimenting and to trying different things out. So I think that was a big shift for my creative process.
If we have this free money, like who's gonna do the jobs? And I think what we have seen and continue to see is that all of us contribute to how we make our society work, right? $1,000 a month is actually not enough, first of all, to not work or receive income in other ways. What I'd also say is that a guaranteed income strengthens worker power in so many ways. Artists are workers amongst other workers as well, right? Artists face the similar financial precarity, living on the waiting for the check to come through, wage theft, all of these things. That's also true for our friends who are doing gig work on platforms. The more people are able to meet their basic needs on their own terms, it raises the possibility of having the systems that we need. Guaranteed income can do things like make space in your life to do the organizing and advocating work that you want to do, right? It gives you the freedom to choose. And what's not more powerful, naysayers, than agency, right, and freedom.
Having that support from GI was the thing that made me reconsider, say, I have this year to invest in myself. I have this year to prove to myself that this is the thing I'm supposed to be following, to rebuild the things that I lost when I lost them, to make that path for myself, to build it if it wasn't clear. So thank you to GI. Thank you for everyone that made this possible. This was massive. Thank you.
I think that guaranteed income is a really critical component to, even if it's corny, but a just, equitable future.
And so for me, the GI grant has provided a space to rest, because we are always burdened with how I'm going to make money, and we don't learn the importance of resting, that nothing
is built for producing all the time that is organic.
My use of this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful guaranteed income has been laying the foundation of how do I now take what has happened to me and go to other women who don't feel that they can step out and tell their stories. How can I help someone through dance, through theater, through visual art, express their journey and their story?
This program has really helped me with, actually, it's really helped me to honor and believe, honor my practice and like believe that the work I do is valuable.
And I guess it's just a winded way of saying that it's not easy to be a working artist and that it's hard to do on your own unless you have a community.
It takes us. It's going to take all of us. And yes, it might take some time, but the time is actually now. In a short amount of time, the last 3 years, we moved from beautiful, important movement work from the 70s, thinking about Ruby Duncan and the National Welfare Women's Rights Organization, King advocating for this and others. There's a lot of precedent and historical context to why we're in this moment. And then just a few years ago, Mayor Tubbs and others gathered mayors across the country, and from a couple of pilots to now hundreds of pilots, which just tells me the more of us are involved, the more this will become a reality for many, many more of us.
Guaranteed income for everyone, which I think is 100% agree. I'm here for it. Where do I sign? It takes kind of like a cultural shift for people to, and a mental shift for people to remember that we are worthy just for being here, and we are worthy to be taken care of.
Thank you all so, so much for being you, for being artists, for making your work, for being a caretaker, for being moms, for just being you.
A lot of you have asked us, like, what's next? How do we do this? How do we keep this going? I mean, I think we heard so much important testimony about the power of guaranteed income for us, for artists, but also for everybody, right? And I just want to double down on what is true and feels true for me for sure, that guaranteed income for all is within reach. Here it is happening right now. In order for that to happen, we have to join the movement, right? We have to be in solidarity with other people, with other workers, with people working on economic justice. I really believe that artists can and have a special place in the movement to do that powerful narrative shifting, right? All the artists I know in my life are advocating for a million things and organizing and doing powerful things in their neighborhood for other people. Now's the time to continue doing it for other people and join up with them, but also do it for ourselves because we all deserve a basic income.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back. I hope you enjoyed those videos. I really did. I'm hoping that we can talk for a second about the videos, if there was anything that resonated with you. Here's where we're not on spotlight anymore. We're in gallery view because the idea is that from this point forward, we're going to start working together. And having conversation around guaranteed income. So were there any thoughts, any learnings from the video that anybody would like to share? Feel free to put them in the chat if that's how you're comfortable, or you can raise your hand so that you can come off mute and talk to the crew, the whole group. Don't be shy. I see Brian and Alicia.
First of all, for me, I heard one of the people speaking talk about it's hard to be an artist without community, and it's essential. And I'm so grateful for IndieSpace for that very reason, and the Episcopal Actors Guild. But also someone else used the term wage theft. And I've experienced that in theater for more than 35 years. Mm-hmm. It's, you dedicate yourself to a production and then, well, we're only going to give you this much after you've done all your work. So I'm good. That's resonated very much with me. Wage theft.
Thank you, Brian. We're just going to do three comments. I see Alicia, then I saw Craig, and then I saw Frank. And then after that, we're going to, I want to talk a little bit about IndieSpace's programs, and we'll go into breakout rooms to have more intimate conversations. Go ahead, Alicia. Or is it Alicia? Am I pronouncing it correctly?
It's Alicia, but I Alicia, still answer sorry, to Alicia. Alicia. It's actually a Spanish name. That's okay. Okay. Thank you for doing this. And I think one of the things that really stood out for me personally is we sometimes feel guilty when we have to ask for help. And we kind of beat ourselves up because we're not living, living at the kind of life or level that we might have anticipated. But the bottom line is that everybody needs help sometimes. And I think what was very educational for me was when the speakers pointed out all of the different programs that have been instituted to help somebody. You know, I think back to 08 when the banking industry was, upon collapse and how we were quick to bail out businesses, but we didn't want to bail out people. And everything is not supposed to, or has to be net permanent, but if you can bail out a business, why can't you bail out people? The very people that the banks robbed. Okay, that's another story. I love that they pointed out all these initiatives from our history, our recent history, actually, that have benefited people. And even as a woman of color, the people that they pointed out had to fight for equity in those programs being administered to all people. So thank you for the educational elements of what they discussed and presented, because it's very affirming for me personally. And I see the merit in this, and it kind of just frees me from the tendency, again, like I was saying at the top of this comment, to feel guilty whenever you have to ask for help sometimes. Thank you.
Thank you. Craig and then Frank. Craig, you're muted.
Am I good now? Okay, great. I enjoyed the videos, and I'm going to try to make this real quick and leave out the verbs and compact this into a real quick sentences here. I've been at the Big Give the last couple times, and I didn't get that. And I know I understand with grants. I just got my NISCA grant application submitted. I just found out this morning that was submitted fine. So, I've gotten a NYFA grant in the past. I've gotten some other support. I've not gotten grants that I've applied for. And I'm on disability. I'm on disability because of a mental health diagnosis. And I'm in a housing program for people that are on disability for that reason. And it's weird, but I told friends of mine that I had a mental health diagnosis. Nobody's really shocked at that. Everybody was like, your mental health issue is like your middle name, Craig. We didn't know what it was, but we knew that you had one, kind of like that. That was the response I got, which was a little frightening. But anyway, neither here nor there. But I'm also a writer and a playwright, and I have a theater company, and I'm also working on a novel. So I take my artistic work very, very seriously, despite the fact that I have problems that have nothing to do with that. And I was thinking about the video, and it's weird because I'm almost going to sound like devil's advocate, like I'm going to sound like the bad guy here for a minute. But it's like I kind of like the fact that money that I get is because I'm a writer. It is because I'm a good writer. It is because my artistic work is valuable, because there's a lot of people in my world that are varying degrees of, having conversations with imaginary objects and talking to lamps and stuff. I it's like intellectually I want help for everyone, but I kind of want to get help because my work, because I'm a good writer. That's what I want my legacy. That's what I want my tombstone. He was a good writer, not he just couldn't fend for himself. You know, he just couldn't feed himself. You know, and I, you know, so it's like I have that kind of weird double-edged thing with that, if that makes any sense at all.
Yeah, well, we all have different feelings and thoughts about this kind of thing. I might suggest it's a yes and, right? Like, this is a we use theater terminology here, and it's wonderful for us to get grants for the work that we're doing. And it's also wonderful to be supported as a human being and for the labor and work that we're contributing to society. It's a yes and. You're fortunate when you're able to receive grants for your creative work. Not everybody does, right? So we have to find, I think, a baseline and some stability, because even with grants, when you're very fortunate, it's constantly like this. There's no stability to depend on, which can be really difficult. So I'm just going to go to Frank. Alexandra, I'm sorry. We just can do one more comment so that we let everybody go on time today, but we'll have more opportunities to share back after the breakout rooms. Frank, do you have something you want to add about the video?
Yes, I definitely want to say a shout out to Craig. I understand your pain. I'm disabled myself physically a few years ago, but I've been an avid writer and director and producer and composer for independent theater. And it's hard. It's very hard. And as much support as you can get, you appreciate. I appreciated the testimony. Everyone that just seems very sincere in their craft and what it is they're trying to do. And it is a struggle. If you don't have that really great job, or if you weren't a privileged child, you're probably securing a few jobs, a couple of hustles here and there. And I just want to do good work. I want to broaden my horizons. I want to be able to work with other people. I want to work together with other producers, like-minded people, so that we can do things together and just expose ourselves. IndieSpace has been very, very good to me over the years, and I've appreciated their support, all of their meetings, all of their functions. Thank you so much, and I'm very glad to be here and just here and know that a program like this can exist for us.
Thank you, Frank. We're happy to have been able to help. And we're really hoping we're going to be able to help a large group of artists with a guaranteed income program. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that. So as I mentioned earlier, IndieSpace has been trying to put together a guaranteed income program for quite some time. And we haven't been able to secure a significant amount of funding for a program like this. So we decided, you know, there's a precedent here for us where we build something and then it grows from there. From our very first Pay Your People grant, we started the Pay Your People program just with one grant to one organization. And now we're giving 65 of those grants out this year with our AAPI Transportation Fund and our Milk and Eggs Fund. We heard from our community that there was a need around a specific issue. We put $10,000 up just to get something started. And each of those programs ended up giving out over $50,000. The Cultural Solidarity Fund, we had $25,000 for an emergency fund. And then together with a coalition of artists and arts workers, I think Michelle is on this call. I think I saw Michelle at some point. We were able to raise over $1.4 million, and we just started with $25,000. So we feel strongly that we will build an equitable, responsive, careful, caring, loving program in community with our people, like in collaboration with our people, and we'll be able to grow it from there. So when Creatives Rebuild, when we've been working together in working groups just to talk about the impact of guaranteed income, Creative Rebuild's approached us to be messaging partners, to get out and spread the word with artists, to do some narrative change work with artists around guaranteed income, so that when politicians are talking about it, when there's potential policy on the table for guaranteed income, we have a group of artists that understands what that language means and is willing to write letters, call their elected officials, go to funders, talk to everybody and anybody that will listen about guaranteed income in order to solidify it as a program or a policy. And the offer to partner with them came with a $5,000 grant, and we have expenses for this Zoom. We have expenses for our event tomorrow, but there's going to be a little money left over. So we thought, okay, that could be the start. We also have a responsive fund where the milk and eggs fund came from, where our AAPI transportation fund came from, so that we can build out a program of our own. I had a hope. My hope is that we could start our guaranteed income program with a minimum of one artist per borough. I'm not sure whether or not we're going to have the funds to do one artist per borough. I know we at least have funds to start with two artists, one or two artists, depending on what we build together today. I want to tell you a little bit about what we think, what we've been thinking about and brainstorming about as far as a guaranteed income program would look like, so that we could level set for the conversations that you all are going to have in the Zoom, in the chat, in the breakout rooms. That's what it's called, in a breakout room. In my ideal world, we would have monthly cash payments of either $500, $750, or $1,000 a month, plus a savings component. One of the things I've been thinking a lot about is the cliff, the funding cliff. What happens when the 18 months is over? What happens when the 2 years is over? So my hope would be that we could have a savings component, an extra $100 or $250 per month that gets put into an escrow account of some sort that is accruing interest over the course of the program, that the artist will get at the end of the program. I would prefer a 2 or 3 year program, as you know, preference would be 3 years, and that there would be coaching, financial coaching and business coaching throughout the entire program. So that at the end of the program, perhaps there would be some new revenue generating idea that could replace whatever the loss of the income would be at the end of the program. And that the money you've saved could actually go to like retirement or a safety net or just sit in savings, because most of the artists that we serve don't have any savings. That would be my dream program. But I want to hear what your dream program looks like. And when we go into the breakout rooms now, I just want to level set a little bit, so that when we're thinking about designing our program, we remember like, yeah, it'd be really awesome if we could each get $10,000 a month for the rest of our lives. But we, I'm truly trying to build a program here. So your feedback, your realistic feedback about a program that would be meaningful, that would really impact your life, but that also we could get spread out to a number of artists would be awesome. So let's think in those terms, like what's enough to matter? How long does it need to be for it to matter? But also so that we can get it to the largest number of artists possible. So the questions that we're gonna copy into the chat and that your breakout room facilitators already have is, what amount of guaranteed income would be most beneficial for independent artists like yourself? What should the duration of the guaranteed income program be to have a meaningful impact on your financial stability and creative work? And what additional support services, financial planning, mental health services, professional development, would you like to see alongside the guaranteed income? And of course, you don't have to have the additional services. It could mean that there's more money, but if you think that would be helpful, what would be helpful? What are we not thinking of? So that's it for right now. We're gonna go into breakout rooms for 20 minutes, and then we're gonna have 10 minutes to share back out and answer some questions. So take it away, Transcend. Hi, everybody. Welcome back. Thank you so much for participating in that. Hey, there's 58 people here post a breakout room. That doesn't usually happen. People are usually like, oh, bye, it's a breakout room. I don't want to talk. I'll see you later. So anyway, thank you so much. I had a really wonderful conversation in my room. I hope you did as well. We're going to do some brief sharing back. And there's a suggested order of the share outs in the chat. Is Azure there to get us started?
Yes, I am. This is Azure D. Osborne Lee in Brooklyn. My pronouns are he and they. And I am going to just give you a quick rundown of what we spoke about in breakout room one. So the consensus on the amount of money was about $750 to $800, which we agreed felt like simultaneously a nice chunk of cheese and also not enough money at all. So there's that. We were really excited about the idea of savings, right? So, and high yield savings accounts, right? Guidance when it comes to how to make that money last, how to get a piece of the pie, so to speak. And yeah, we also talked about work trades, like potentially having a runway out of a program. We thought the program should be 2 years minimum. And we're looking at ways to plug into alternate economies. And I think that is all I'll say. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Pamela, then Nidra, yeah, then Shigu.
You called me because I had so many rich ideas. I didn't have had a chance to type it down, but I found it very exciting. People really thought it was a range from they could spend it, they would be able to do the guarantee almost immediately because what they were concentrated on was compensating their colleagues to get their productions up. They wanted to pay people fairly. And that goes back to one person said that what it would mean for him is that he wouldn't have to scrimp and save and say, oh, okay, I won't pay Con Ed this month so that I can have more rehearsal space. He said people could have longer rehearsals, they could have them in better places, and they could have larger productions. And then some of the other things they would pay for were classes, writing classes, acting classes, and the compensation again to their colleagues. So they also were hoping, when you ask what they might be able to do in addition, they would like help to get affordable venues for independent work, maybe that you could somehow partner up with another organization and support them finding places, better places to produce their work. And then also someone that I think you already have something going on like this, but they would like office space that they could do official meetings with people so that they weren't doing them in their bedrooms or like having to put it in with the rehearsals. And the office space, somebody also said with that, they would love to have printing. They'd love to be able to give scripts to people. And then they would also like help with learning about affordable housing. And that was the main thing. And as far as the amount, they said they would be happy with 500 to 1,000, that they could do enough with it that their lives would be better.
Awesome. Nidra?
Hi, everyone. My group was amazing. Can I just say that? Bernard, Kendra, Melissa, Mia, shout out. So pretty much across the board, they all agreed that 1,000 would be the bare minimum for what would be helpful per month. Bernard also said that he loves that wouldn't prevent him from having another gig. You know, you just know that you have that cushion. As far as the duration, everyone agreed somewhere between 2 to 3 years. And Melissa made this really great point that in order to like have an idea, let it live and then release it into the world, 3 years is really ideal to be able to have like healthy, energetic time period to do something meaningful. And then additional services, a few people said like retirement income and learning about retirement, financial wellness support, marketing training, like how can we make the most of the work we put out into the world? Mental health resources was echoed a couple of times, especially Mia said, when you're accepted into a program like this and it ends, some may have like the blues, you know, like post-show blues, and also learning about investing. They'd love to know how to make more money after the 3 years, Kendra said. Those are the big points.
Awesome. And I just want, thank you for that. I want to just be mindful of the time. I'm realizing we're running out of time quickly. Maybe we are able to stay like 2 or 3 minutes beyond 7:30, but Shegu, then Brad. Are you here, Shegu?
Yes, I'm here. Just moving to a place where you can all hear me. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yes.
Yes. So when it came to I'm just gonna go because of time. I'm not gonna go in order of the questions and how they were asked. One thing that came up for us was sort of arbitrary to throw out a number and try to come up with a something that would work and fix. So Sammy Morales actually suggested coming up with some sort of metric or mean based around nationwide debt. And Sam, I would encourage you to share something in our link. You can share that with the larger group. That would be great. But that was something that was discussed that seemed pretty profound and very helpful. The next thing was a concern about the actual application process and how eligibility will be constructed. That was a point of concern. And also looking out for international artists, making sure that we're not forgetting them and then keeping them in mind. The next thing came about, artists, there's all this pressure on artists and all this pressure on us, and then sometimes you don't have the know-it-all or the energy to actually promote your work. So there was a conversation around marketing assistance or marketing education, maybe a little bit of the two to help with to help with the stress of getting the artist's work to be seen, validated, promoted in any type of capacity. Agreed on the time of year, beyond a year, part of your making this a part of your daily practice, so it seems logical for it to run for 2 or 3 years to collect data, so that this is something that we can actually study. Was something that came up in our group. And the last thing was when it comes to other services, financial planning, mental health services, it seemed like everyone agreed on that, but then also having that something that is that is already decided for you, not an opt-in or opt-out decision when it comes to the program. And that's it for us.
Thank you. I want to make sure too, I hope all of our facilitators took notes in the document because we're going to take the document. I know we're not going to get to everything. Brad and Maya, anything special off the top that you think that hasn't been mentioned yet that you'd want to add?
Yeah, somebody mentioned an idea of alternate year and amounts with different years needing different amounts, 500 a month 1 year, 1,000 a month the second year, which I thought spoke to this idea of having some agency in deciding for yourself how much money and when and how it gets dispersed. And then I thought an interesting comment was somebody had their rent paid for a month for them, and they noticed that the higher the amount of support, the more time you'd actually be able to give to your art making, which would allow you to do the amount more that you would need to do, whereas a lower amount might support keeping you going at the pace that you're at, but doesn't really alter the way in which you could engage your own work and transformatively put something on to bring in the kind of money at the end of the cliff.
We talked
Cool.
about my.
Go
I was
for it,
just going to
Maria.
jump in.
Right. Go ahead.
My group shared so many wonderful things, so thank you all. We talked a little bit about tiered support in some ways, like having a larger group of people who got a smaller amount of support and a smaller group of people who got a largest amount of support, possibly doing it by area or neighborhood or borough, how much support you got, depending on the cost of living in your area. We also talked about the importance not only of future financial planning, but also past. So like paying off debt or things like that. Any way we could coordinate with existing programs such as job placement, with which Joyce shared in the chat. And then I think we got there was like a big range of how much money it should be and how long, but I think at least 1K per month on the high, and then for 2 years. Some folks recognize that there was like probably initial shock of getting that kind of support, and that you would need to settle into it a little bit to feel it.
Awesome. I just want to honor everybody's time. It's 7:32. I'm okay. I really need to know if our ASL interpreters and our producers are okay staying on for an extra, just like really 3 more minutes, if that's okay with others, so we can finish out. Okay. All right. Very quick, Joelle, I don't remember who was next from our team. Vashante, Joelle, in India, any new things that haven't
new
been mentioned
team. I think, thank you for my group. I think something that we talked was like the conversation about time and amount flexible, depending on the person, can be on the landscape of the economic situation, can be flexible in time, also amount. And other saving, other thing that we can add can be artist mentorship, legal help, and a check-in during the process.
Very similarly, but also just a new thing. We really talked a lot about like how housing being the largest aspect of people's like monthly budget, wanting to do whatever the amount, like choosing the amount based off of what the actual cost of living and the cost of rent in the city is, and making sure that we were able to take a sizable chunk from that amount.
Yeah, on my end, it was very similar. I think the range was 500 to 700. Some of us was thinking 2 years tops, just to make room for other artists. We thought about like a rolling thing where as the money come, we add more people on so that people aren't waiting in those 2 or 5 year increments. And lastly, for the last question, classes on like how to negotiate for yourself, how to build contracts and stand as an artist and say, these are my services and this is what I stand for. Also like giving negotiation room for people that may not be able to afford the prices, things like that. And building a website, stuff, you know, things outside of the actual art itself.
Awesome. I'll just name 2 things that were mentioned in my room that haven't been mentioned yet. One was, if we were doing a savings component, that the money might be pooled all together for who at all the members of the program in a savings account, a high interest savings account, so that it earns additional interest, and that that all can be split at the end of the program so that we're using each other's to benefit all of us. And then another thing that was mentioned that wasn't mentioned before, additional health coaching was something that somebody, like having a little extra money might mean people go to the doctor for the first time in a really long time. And so aside from financial coaching and business coaching, health coach was also mentioned. So that was really rushed. I wish we had 30 minutes at least for this part of the conversation so that we could keep the conversation going. I want to thank you all very much for being here and for contributing your ideas and your thoughts and for sending good energy towards us building something. It's scary to build something that we know can be big, but we think it's worth it. And we're going to take all of your feedback into consideration. We're going to go through the written notes from all of our facilitators, and we plan to roll something out this year. I mean, the goal is to just do it, build it, they will come, and we'll keep you all in the loop. My hope is that if we put the framework together and we are able to deal with whatever the application process might be, I have no idea if we'll be able to, we most likely will not be able to open it widely at the beginning if we're only doing it for a small number of people. We'll most likely take a look at folks that have applied for our emergency funding in the last couple of years and have an opt-in application so that we can manage it. If we are not receiving a grant to do this program, we probably don't have the capacity to. I mean, I don't know if Mara's still here, but I think they received like 60,000 applications for their program, and we are a team of 4. So we are going to do our best to build something, and we promise when the money comes, I love the staggering, right? Like as the money comes, more people get folded into the program. Oh, the other thing that my group mentioned is the one cohort then advises and supports the following cohort. So as you roll out of the program, you become a support system for the folks that are just gaining access to this support. So we thought that was wonderful. I am just gonna say thank you so, so much to our ASL interpreter, Stephanie and Cami, and to Transcend, our producers, Kira and Liana, for helping us, and to Mara for coming here and for mentoring me and teaching me so much about guaranteed income over the last year or so. And to my, I'm forgetting everybody, but my team, and also you all, because we have the best community. I love my community. Thank you for being here and contributing to the conversation. Fingers crossed, we have a good group tomorrow in person. And you'll be hearing from us soon.
Yeah. Any question, last minute, you can email us on hello@indiespace.org.
Yes, exactly, Joel. Thank you. Thank you,
to our facilitators. Thank you all.
Oh, yes, that's who else. Thank you, facilitators.
Thank you.
Everybody. Good night, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you. Good night. Thank you. Bye.